Now, it's important to remember that we're not here to teach you how to build a weather app. It's not even to teach you all of the Android APIs that we'll use to build it. It's really about retraining your brain to start thinking like a mobile developer, which is really important because at the end of this course, we're going to ask you to build your own final project. We're expecting you to already be familiar with object-oriented programming and to have experience with Java or a similar language. Personally, I got started with Android after years of Delphi and C# development. As engineers, we're trained to map our experiences in one language or SDK into new ones, looking for patterns and shortcuts so we can get up to speed as quickly as possible. But mobile, and Android in particular, has some fundamental differences that mean some of our experience and intuition will actually make us worse mobile engineers. We like to think of smartphones as computers that fit into our pockets. In a way, that's true. But they're computers from the 90s, like this powerhouse I was using nearly 20 years ago. With limited internet connectivity, low-speed CPUs, and limited RAM, on top of which they're all running on batteries. As we go through the course, I'll be returning to each of these key mobile challenges, looking for places where your experience on desktop or server or even other mobile platforms might lead you in the wrong direction. I'll also be back to tell you some stories from the early days of Android. Stories that describe how the Android platform has evolved. And nowhere is that more readily apparent than here at the Android Lawn Sculpture Garden. Join me here at the very heart of Android at the end of this lesson to find out how this sculpture garden of tasty treats also tells the story of Android's history. For now, let's get back to building that weather app. So we'll cross to Dan to take a look at some mocks.